The next problem, building deterministic finite state machine from a non-deterministic finite state machine. Okay, so you're building DFSM from the given NDFSM. So what is the question? Compute or convert the following non-deterministic FSM to deterministic FSM. So the diagram is given here. Okay, the diagram is given, a non-deterministic FSM, so you have to convert it. So you have certain procedures to convert the given thing to a other DFSM. So here you have to consider each and every state. So I'll tell you step by step procedure. So step one, so computing EPS of Q. So you should find the epsilon transitions with respect to each and every state. So altogether, how many states do you have here? You have from state 0 to state 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So altogether 10 states you have in this particular DFA. So with respect to each state, you need to find out this. So how to find EPS of a particular state, you have seen in previous video. So the same thing will continue now. So we shall find EPS with respect to each state. So first I'll find out EPS of the first state is 0. So what is EPS of 0? So first to itself 0. So from 0 I don't have any epsilon transitions to any other state. So EPS of 0 is 0 itself. Next I'll find out EPS of 1. So EPS of 1 is to itself. So from 1 I don't have any epsilon transition, so it is only 1. Next I'll consider EPS of 2. So it is 2. So from 2 the transition goes to 3. So next is 3. Next, from 2 it also goes to 9. So from 3 it goes to 4. So from 4 it goes nowhere. So from 3 it goes to 6. From 6 it goes nowhere. Okay. So from 2 it will go to 3. So from 3 it goes to state 4. So from 4 I don't have any epsilon transition. Okay. Next, from 3 it goes to 6. From 6 I don't have any epsilon transition. Next, from 2 it also goes to 9. So from 9 I don't have any other epsilon transitions. So I am done with this. Similarly, write with respect to EPS of 3. So first to itself 3. So from 3 I have epsilon transition to 4. So from 4 I don't have anywhere. So from 3 I have transition to 6. So from 6 I don't have anywhere. So EPS of 3 is 3, 4, 6. Similarly, find for all other states. So EPS of 4 is to itself, I don't have any other transition. Next, EPS of 5. Okay, EPS of 5, you have to refer the same diagram and you have to write for all 10 states. So refer the diagram, I'll go on writing here now. So EPS of 5 next is, it is to 5 itself. Okay. So from 5 it goes to 8, and then you have 8 it goes to 9, and then from 8 it also comes back to 3. From 3 you have it to 4, and from 3 you have it to 6. Okay, so you can check out the diagram and write it on your own. Then EPS of 6, so to itself, and you don't have anything further. Then EPS of 7, so to itself 7. So from 7 you have transition to 8. So from 8 you have transition to 9. From 8 you also have a transition to 3. So from 3 you have a transition to 4, and then you have a transition to 6. Then EPS of 8. EPS of 8 is to itself 8. So from 8 you have a transition to 9. From 8 you have a transition to 3. From 3 you have to 4 and then 6. Next, EPS of 9. EPS of 9 is 9. From 9, you don't have transition anywhere. So, this is the end. So, EPS of 9 is 9. So, I am done with this. Next, we shall go to step 2. Okay, step 2. So, what is step 2? So, you have to consider which is the starting state. So, in this diagram, you have a starting state as, what is the starting state here? Starting state is 0. Okay, starting state is 0. So, in step 2, you have to find what is the EPS of the starting state. Okay, you have already found out. You have to just consider that. Okay, I'll write step 2 now. Step 2, you're computing S dash, where S dash is a start state. That is, you're finding out S dash, that is nothing but EPS of start state. Okay, EPS of start state. So, what is the start state here? It is 0. So, EPS of 0. So, from the problem, what did you get EPS of 0? EPS of 0 is 0. Okay, EPS of 0 is 0. So, from step 2, you got certain states now. So, I got state as 0. Next, you should go to step 3. So, in step 3, you are finding the computing the transition functions. Okay, with respect to each state, with respect to every input that goes out from that particular state, you will keep on continuing finding the active states till you get no more active states. Okay, so you should go on finding out active states for each and every state with respect to inputs till you get no more new active states. So I'll write step 3 now. So step 3. So what is step 3? You're computing the transition function. Okay. So what I need to do? What did you get in step 2? In step 2, you got the answer as 0, right? So you got the answer as 0. So just find out delta of, what did you get? You just got 0. Okay. So, from 0, with respect to the given example, how many alphabets do you have? So, in the diagram, you can notice that you have only two, other than epsilon, you have only two other alphabets. That is A and then B. Okay, one is A and then B. So, with respect to whatever answer you got, so from this particular state, you have to consider A and then also delta of 0 comma B. So what is this? Okay, what is this? Here what you're doing is you're checking the diagram every time. Okay, checking the diagram. So what did you got? Did get 0, right? So from 0, if you read A, to which state will you go? So in this example, from 0, if I read A, I will go to state 1. Okay, so from 0, if I read B, where will I go? Okay, so from 0, if I read A, it is 1. So from 0, I don't have any outgoing transition with respect to B. So if that is the case, what should I consider? If you don't have any transition, then take it as 5. And epsilon of 5 will always be 5. That is, so I'll write here. So from state 0, if I read A, it will go to state 1. Okay, it will go to state 1. So once you get this, next you have to find out what is epsilon of this particular state, that is epsilon of 1. So you have already found out what is epsilon of 1. EPS of 1 is nothing but 1. Okay, so you are done with this. Next, similarly write with respect to B. So from state 0, you don't have any outgoing state with respect to B, so it is taken as 5. Next, find out what is EPS of 5. EPS of 5 is nothing but 5 itself. Okay, you're done with this. So once you're done with this, you have to find out which are the different active states. So what are the active states? Okay. So initially, what was the active state that you got from the starting state in step 2? In step 2, you got EPS of 0 as 0, right? So this was already there. So what is the new set of states that you have got? So this is a new active state, that is 1. Another active state that you have got is 5. Another active state that you have got is 5. So compared to previous one, in previous I only had 0. Now I got 2 new active states, that is 1 and 5. So what I should do, I should continue the same procedure. Okay. So next what I'll do is, with respect to 0 I already found out. Next I will find out with respect to 1, and then I'll find out with respect to 5. So after finding out, I'll check which are the new active states. So if I get a new active state, once again I should continue this procedure till the end, till I get no more new active states. So I'll continue. So I have to find with respect to 1 and 5. So first I'll tell you what happens if you get 5. So if it is 5, directly you can write delta of, what is this 5, right? So from 5, if you read A, where will it go? From 5, if you read B, where will it go? So when you have 5, no matter what transitions you have, it is 5 itself. Okay, I'm done with this. Next I'll find, so with respect to 0 it is already done. With respect to 5 I have written. Next I'll write with respect to 1. Okay, I'll write with respect to 1. So before writing with respect to 1, this is a new calculation. I'll write the new set of active states. Active states are, so 0, 1, 5, these three were already present. So from new calculation, what did you get? You got 5 again, which is already present. So I'm done with this. So you can notice that here with respect to this you have calculated, here with respect to this you have calculated. So after calculating, this and this is done. So what is remaining? 1 is remaining. So I should follow the same procedure with respect to 1, that is from state 1, if I read A, where will I go? From 1, if I read B, where will I go? So here, transition, with respect to 1, if I read A, where will the transition go to? So from 1, if I read B, where will the transition go to? So for every time you have to see the diagram, so you can see here. So from 1, if I read A, where will it go? So I don't have A, so it is 5. So from 1, if I read B, where will the transition go? So from 1, if you read B, the transition will go to 2. So we shall write these two things. So from 1, I don't have any A, so it is 5. So what is EPS of 5? It is nothing but 5 itself. Then from state 1, if I read B, I will go to state 2. Next, what is EPS of 2? So you have already found out EPS of 2. What is EPS of 2? EPS of 2 is 2, 3, 4, 6 and then 9. So you are done with this. With respect to 1, A and B is done. Now we shall write the new set of active states. So what is the new set of active states? Active states. So whatever was already present, write it as it is. So 0, 1, 5. So after calculating, you got a new set here. Okay, you got a new set. Just write that. That is 2, 3, 4, 6, 9. Okay. So this is a active state. Check whether you have anything new. So with respect to this, this one and this you have already calculated. So this is a new active state here. So once again follow the same procedure with respect to this. So with respect to this state, you should check transition for A and then transition with respect to B. So in this, you can notice that there are more than one state in a set. So what to do if this is the case? So I will just write the same state, that is 2, 3, 4, 6, 9. So from this state, if I read A, what happens? So from this state, if I read B, what happens? So when you have more than one state in a set, you just split it individually and then find the union of everything. That is, with respect to 2, input A, union, next is 3, right? 3, A, union, next transition with respect to 4, A, union, next transition is with respect to 6, A, union, next transition is with respect to 9, A. So with respect to each unit to find. So check the diagram again. Okay, check the diagram again. Check from state 2, if you read A, you will go to which state. So for everything you have to refer the diagram. So from 2, if I read A, where will it go? Nowhere, so it is 5. Okay. Similarly from 3. From 3, if you read A, where will it go? Nowhere, it is 5. So next I'll consider, what do you have? 4. So from 4, if you read A, where will it go? It will go to state 5. Similarly, check for everything and write. So here, from 2, if I read, I don't have A, so it is 5. Union. From 3, I don't have A, so it is 5. Union. From 4, if I read A, it will go to state 5. Union. From 6, I don't have A. Union. From 9 also, I don't have A. Okay? So find the union of all these things. So union of all these things will be 5. So with respect to this state and the alphabet A, you got the answer as 5. Now find out what is EPS of 5. So you have already found out what is EPS of 5. So what is EPS of 5? EPS of 5. So what is EPS of 5? It is 5, 8, 9, 3, 4 and then 6. Okay, which you have already found out. So I'll just rearrange this and write. So it is 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 and then 9. I just wrote it in order. Okay, so I'm done with this. So with respect to this state, with respect to A you have written, do the same thing with respect to B. That is 2, 3, 4, 6, 9. If you read B, what is the transition? So write it individually. So 2, B, union. 3, B, union, 4, B, union, 6, B, union, 9, B. So go through the diagram and check which are the different states reachable. So from 2, if I read A, B, from 2, if I read B, it goes nowhere, so it is 5. From 3 also, I don't have B. From 4 also I don't have B. Next from 6. From 6 if I read B, it will go to state 7. From 9 I don't have B, so it is 5. So union of all these things is 7. So find out EPS of 7. So EPS of 7 is 7, 8, 9, 3, 4. And then 6. So I will just rearrange this and write. That is 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. you're done with this. Okay, you're done with A, you're done with B. So now you have to write a new set of active states. This active states. Write the previous one as it is, that is 0, 1, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9. Check whether you have got anything new. So these are the two states, set of states that you have got. Whether this is already existing? No, it is not existing. So include that. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. This one, whether this is present, 3, 4, no, even this is not present. So here you don't have 5, okay, in this new state you don't have 5, here you have 5. So next include this also, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these are the new set of active states. So here you have found out with respect to this one, this is done, 5 is done, even this is done. So these two are new active states. So once again, follow the same procedure like you have done here. Okay, the same thing. So with respect to 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, check if it reads A, what is the transition? So with respect to this, if you read B, what is the transition? Similarly, with respect to this. So with respect to 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, if you read A, what is the transition? If you read B, what is the transition? Okay, so go on calculating till you get a new state. Okay. So I have already found out with respect to next state. Okay, next set A and next set B. So I ended up with this and this solution. So I got EPS of 7. So I just rearranged it and wrote. And here EPS of 5 and here EPS of 7. I just arranged it and wrote. So once I am done with this, I will write a new set of active states. So active states. So previous values, write it as it is. So previously I had 0, I had 1, I had 5, and then 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, and then I had 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, and then 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, this I already had. So with respect to this, I found out. So when I found out, I got this new state. 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. Check whether it is present. 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. It is already present, so don't include it. Okay, so this is the next one you got. That is 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. Check whether it is present. Yes, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9 is already present. Since it is already present, you need not include it here. So you're done with the active states. So you're done with this, this is done. When this is done, you have calculated transitions with respect to this state also. Now this is remaining. Okay. So follow the same procedure. So with respect to this state, with respect to A, check the transitions. Then with respect to B, check the next transition. So next, so with respect to 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, A and B, I have already found out. So you'll be getting this. So active states. So these are the existing active states. So we shall check, do we have anything new? Okay, so I got 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9 is already present. Then 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9 is also already present. So you have found out with respect to all these states. So when you ended up here, you didn't get any new states. Okay, you didn't get any new active states. So your step 3 stops here. Okay, you didn't get any new active states. So step 3 will stop here. So next we shall go to step 4. So what is step 4? Step 4 is the final active states that you have got. Okay, this itself will be the step 4. So So I'll write step 4 and I will copy this as it is. So step 4, so whatever active states you got, write the active states. Okay, so this will be K dash, that is the new set of active states that you have got. Next I'll write step 5. So what is step 5? Step 5 is you have to write a set of a final state. Okay, so which is the final state now? So in the original diagram, okay, in the question, what was the final state? Final state was 9. Okay, final state was 9. So after converting, so what will be the final state? So I have different sets here, that is 0, 1, 5. I have a set here, here, and then here. Check where do you have 9. So I have 9 in this set. I have 9 in this set. I have 9 in this set also. So these three sets becomes my final state. So my accepting state will be, so 2, 3, 4, 6, 9. That is this one. Next I have 9 here also. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. And then this one. That is 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So these three becomes the accepting state. So I have reached step 5. So once I am done with this, we shall draw the final diagram. So I have different states. So with respect to states, just go on drawing. So it will be start. Okay. So it is start. So first state, what is that? 0. I'll consider 0. Next it is 1. This 5 you need not write. Then this will be the next state. I'll just write it here, okay? So 0, and then I have 1. Then I have this one. So the set is 2, 3, 4, 6, 9. Okay, one more is this one, that is set 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. And then the last one, I'll write it here, that is set 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 states. So out of these 5 states, which are the final states, wherever you have 9, it becomes the final states. So this is the final state. This is also a final state. And then this is also the final state. Next you have to write transition, that is from 0. If I read A, where will the transition go to? So if I read B, where will the transition go to? So to do this, you have to refer step 3. Okay, in step 3, you have written procedure wise with respect to each state and each alphabet. So with respect to that, you need to write. That is, so you have here, where is it? This one, okay? So from 0, if you read A, where will it go? It will go to state 1. So from 0, if you read B, what happens? It is 5. So you need not write. Okay, so from 0, if I read A, it will go to 1. Okay, similarly from state 1. So from 1, if I read A, it will go nowhere. From 1, if I read B, where will it go? From 1, if I read B, it will go to 2, 3, 4, 6, 9. Similarly, here. So from 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, if I read A, it will go to this state. So if I read B, it will go to this state. So check everywhere and then go on doing the transition. So here, so from 0, if I read A, it will go to 1. So from 1, if I read B, it will go to this set. From this set, if I read A, it will go to 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. So from this, if I read B, it goes to 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. then from this particular state, if I read A, it goes to itself. So if I read B, it comes to this state. And then from 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, if I read A, okay, if I read A, it goes to this state. If I read B, it goes to itself. Okay, so the conversion is done. So what was the question? The question was, convert the given non-deterministic finite state machine to deterministic finite state machine. So the conversion is done. So this is one problem. So all the problems are similar. Okay, the same procedure should be followed.